Welcome to Real Cool Adventures. Today we're hunting garfish with the air javelin right now. Ooh, big old fish right there. We were trying to show you guys the layout of the land and all of a sudden something happened. The drone crashed. We'll show you that footage in a second. But for now, we gotta go capture the drone, check my pocket. We'll be right back.
This is what friends are for.
I just don't know how I'm gonna get back up. Story of my life. Mother Nature's hot tub right there, baby. Stop dropping the ball. Uh-oh. Well, the good news, the bad news. Drone. Honey badgers! Swim in boots, kids. What was that? Here I come to save the day. I swear I'm gonna quit. This rock is sharp. I just got violated by a barnacle.
That was just me. I would have just chalked that drone up to a loss, a write-off.
I'll tell you what, in all honesty, I'm coming back here to my new swimming hole. The water's
spring good to fed. Go. Good, it's all in one piece.
It's not that bad.
Good, good to go.
Missing a little bit of air.
Yeah.
But, all right, let's get back to the action. Have fun.
Thanks, Mike.
No problem. Ooh. That's why I almost... Cool part about that too is you can pee and it self-warms. It's like a homemade heater. All right. One drone
We're
down.
We're back.
This, my friends, is our new best friend. I have no idea how to use it. Comes with instructions. You've seen our videos before. You can't figure stuff out unless you use it. Take that, put that somewhere it won't blow away. And always use gun safety. Pretty much similar to any other type of gun. Whoa. I think what I'm gonna do is take that out. All right, we gotta fill with air. All right, once again, this is the Umarex air gun. Air javelin, I think I called it something else before. 300 feet per second, what it says it does. Whether or not it does that could be a whole different thing. We're gonna be using a larger head, or tip, whatever. I say things improperly, obviously, sometimes, whatever. We're gonna be using a heavier arrow, a fishing style tip. So I would assume that's gonna really slow it down. So whatever it says in the box is irrelevant. And a big shout out to all my friends in Indonesia and the Philippines for recommending this Tiksay, which is, Tiksay is really just a style of hunting that they do over there. We do the same thing here, we call it something different. And it's basically when you have an arrow attached to a string or a tether, something like that, and you shoot that projectile with air, or you can even use a slingshot or some other methods. So there's nobody in the background, it's really safe. A lot of my shots, I'm assuming today, are gonna be within 5 to 15 yards. So I'm just gonna use these peep sights. I'm gonna aim at a leaf on the ground. And it didn't work. So, how do you charge it? I have no idea. We'll go to a commercial.
Good thing you tore up those directions.
Whatever. Those of you don't know and you ever have any questions about anything to do with air guns, check out Air Gun Evolution YouTube channel. My buddy Steve, he's like walking directions.
Give him a call.
I'm gonna do it right now. I'm gonna call him. And if you guys want, I could post his personal cell phone number. He probably won't want me to do that.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Hey, how are you? I got a major emergency. I'm sorry to bother you on the weekend. This air javelin, I'm getting ready to shoot it, and I've got literally catfish running all over the place. So I loaded the cartridge, the air in there. I pushed the bolt back in. The directions, it didn't come with any directions.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened to them. You might want to call them and tell them that they're not putting directions in these boxes. But my next question for you is, how do I make it shoot?
So you push the bolt all the way in, right?
Oh yeah.
Never charge the gun and then push the bolt in just for a safety thing.
Okay, I don't think I did that.
Yeah, in case it fires, you know, you don't want it going into your hand.
Oh yeah, yeah.
There should be like a little, the bolt should stop and then it should almost like click on. There's like a little O-ring that you gotta just push it over.
Mm-hmm, I had that happen.
So you screwed the thing in, right? The charging bolt in.
Oh, yeah. You mean the little handle thing?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's on there. Is it okay for right hand or left hand?
You can make it either or.
Oh, I think I fixed the problem. This one was defective. No, not really. Okay, I didn't put the charging bolt on. Oh.
Okay.
I figured it out.
All right.
Thank you, Steve. I love you. And I'll see you soon. Once again, that's Steve at Air Gun Evolution. He's like the best guy in the world at engineering this stuff. Did I hang up on him? Sorry, Steve. Okay, we're back. Enough of the boring stuff. So now I'm just gonna point at a leaf. Let's see these little sights, how accurate they are. Ooh. That's gonna leave a mark. All right, so it's just that easy to set up. This is obviously important, and it comes where you can actually set it up left hand or right hand. I just set it up the way it was laying down on the ground, but I do think that'll feel better. And enough about this. Once again, this is the Umarex, what's it called?
Air Javelin.
Umarex Air Javelin. Obviously, we have no affiliation with any of these people, so let's go have fun. Let's go find some fish and take them out right now. Well, this spot looks creepy. Then you just reel it back in like that. That was my first practice shot. Oh, got stage fright. Normally I have Lauren do this with me. Ready? You just go dancing in the dark, you know, a little conversation. Did you know? I've been holding down the back seat of a black limousine, saying everyone around me is gonna get the green, you know. I got my eyes. Are you kidding me? That was the most flawless, humane thing I've ever seen in my life. I don't even have to get in the water. We've got dinner. Perfect eating size. We'll go ahead and get one more because they only have a little loin on them. And that's it. Welcome to Real Cool Adventures. Today we're hunting garfish. And as you can see, they're swimming all along here. A lot of people consider these trash fish. I don't. We're just gonna shoot what we can eat. And I have no idea why they keep coming up here. They're suicidal. Snap, crackle, pop. Watch the garfish drop. Please don't leave. this thing. Thank you to everybody at the Philippines, everybody down, everybody that's watched Real Code Adventures, and anybody who hasn't subscribed, do us a favor, go ahead and subscribe, leave a comment down below, because that helps us in the long run. And this Tixay stuff is one of the coolest things I've ever tried. Today's the first time I've honestly ever done it that way, and you see how effective it is. Let's do it again. I've been waiting all my life for this. Woo! Got him. Take a drag. Is that shot number 12? I don't really know. So come on, don't tell me I'm gone. Let's try to work it out. Barely in him. That thing's got so much power, it broke the ball. Woo! I didn't get any more fun than that. Now, Cam and I were arguing in the car about this thing, how reliable it's gonna be. I was skeptical of it at first.
I've been telling you to do this for months.
I know. Well, watch this. I'm gonna do this. I'm about to do this right here. You're going in the cooler, buddy. You see him coming? What is he thinking? I'll tell you what he's thinking. Game over. That's it. That is the most ethical hunting scenario cigar I've ever seen. Woo! We got dinner. I can sit here and do this all day. It's more than enough to eat. So let's get out of here. Yes. Boom. So that's Tixay hunting with Real Cool Adventures. We'll see you on the next adventure. Hope you enjoyed it. It's just that simple. Check out that thing. Woo!